Hello there, lovely people, it's Alex from Nintendo Life here, and if you haven't played Monster Hunter Generations Ultimate, why are you on this video? Because today we're going to be looking at how you can get into the game if you're a little bit put off by it, or maybe you've bought it and you've just gone in and you're going, ah! They're complicated games, there's no denying that, and so it can be very, well, just overwhelming for a lot of people to just dive right into it. So we thought we'd do this. Also, I love Monster Hunter and I just wanted to do another video on it. But anyway, that's more than enough waffling, let's dive right into things. I'm going to start off with one of the most important ones of all, critical distance. Please, please learn what critical distance is, or you're going to have a very, very bad time, at least as a gunner. Basically, when you're using a ranged weapon, a bow gun, a heavy bow gun, or a bow, then you need to take into account how far away from the monster you are whenever you unleash an attack. If you're using a ranged weapon and you keep seeing this, a sort of a faint red flash, then you're doing basically no damage. I think it's like 40% damage, which is rubbish. What you want to be seeing is this white flash with a bit of orange in it, and more importantly, notice that the screen is shaking. That is your ticket to dealing the most damage. Bowguns are fairly forgiving with this and actually have quite a large critical distance area, but bows are pretty pernickety to say the least. You need to be aware of what shot you're using and of course how far away you are, because each shot is different as well. I'm not going to go into enormous detail here because this is only a very brief beginner's guide, but I do highly recommend this video by Gaijin Hunter, or indeed it might be three videos, because I think actually they're split into three now I think about it. But in short, if you see a flash of red, you need to get closer. It's not the ranged weapon you expect it to be, it's actually kind of just like a mid-range thing. White and orange with a shaky screen, that's your key to victory. I was hoping that would rhyme. When you're playing online and you don't know who you're playing with, you're probably going to want to be able to communicate at least to some degree. Now there are the sort of the quick chat options, and you can use the on-screen keyboard, but honestly that's not very efficient when you've got a Rathalos up your bum. But if you just plug in a USB keyboard, you can just use that. Just hit enter, type away, and that'll appear on screen. It's easy peasy.
You could even buy one of these if you wanted to, but you shouldn't because it's really, really horrible.
It sounds like something you don't need to worry about, but if you know where the monster is because you've taken a psycho serum or something like that, or you happen to be playing as a prowler, you can really help the team by letting them know where the monster is instead of just hoping they follow you. Slam a keyboard in there, do it the old-fashioned way for a change. If the whole game seems just a little bit overwhelming and there's too much to think about and you just can't get your head around it, try out prowler mode. If you go to the Palico Ranch, you can switch mode into prowler mode and run around as one of your palicos, which are the little cats that follow you around. This mode doesn't have as many options as the standard hunter, but as a result, that makes it a lot more straightforward, and more importantly, a lot simpler. You don't have to worry about item management because you can't use items, instead you've got a series of skills and support abilities to help you and your team in order to beat that monster. You've also got infinite stamina. You don't have to worry about items, I can't stress enough how much easier it is without worrying about items. You don't have to concern yourself with ammo, you're ranged and close combat equipped, and you don't have to worry about items. Also, you can see the monster whenever you like, which is really damn useful. Not saying you should stay like this forever though, eventually it is definitely worth upgrading and graduating to a good old-fashioned human. You might not have seen them, but tutorials do exist. If you have a look on screen, you can see where they are hidden in the quest menu, and it's sounds like a really stupid and blatant thing, but I had no idea these were in there until I was reading the review that we wrote for Nintendo Life. So please do look at the tutorials and do the tutorials if you haven't done it and you haven't played the game before, because otherwise you're going to have a very bad time. Every time you go on a hunt, always eat a meal. They only cost 50 zenny each, which is just a pittance, and they are so useful. They boost your stamina, they boost your health, and they can give you special abilities that can help even in gathering quests. Even if you're just going to get some mushrooms, eat a meal, because you never know when you're going to get a great macaw in your face. Never, ever let your health get below half, especially early on in the game. Large monsters might not look like they're doing that much damage, but holy sweet bejeebus, they are. And if you're not keeping an eye on your health, they will kill you very quickly, and more importantly,
very easily. If you just make it a rule that your health can never get below half, you will do much better. Just run off, find a little safe corner, or find a brief moment when the enemy's not attacking you, and glug one of those potions down. In fact, it might be better to be a mega potion. No matter what weapon you're using, read the hunter's notes about the control scheme. Monster Hunter's controls have never been terribly intuitive, and there are so many things like using X and A at the same time that will perform different moves that you didn't know you had if you just picked up the game and assumed you had X, A, and maybe R at a push. It also lists combos, and there's one each individual entry for each different fighting style. What the hell are they called? Hunting styles, that's it. Even if you think you know a weapon, have a look, and it will hopefully tell you something you didn't know. Because my god, I learned some new things the other day, and I've been playing Monster Hunter for about 5 years. Lastly, and most importantly, and arguably even the most sort of cheaply, just use the damned internet. I know a lot of people who will say, oh, I don't want to look at the internet, I don't want spoilers, I don't want to see, I don't want to have the answer given to me, I don't want to be spoon-fed, and that's absolutely fine, but Monster Hunter is a series where you basically can't do it without a guide, and the internet is now your guide. There are loads of resources out there, there are articles, there are wikis, there's everything you could possibly need, and if you don't know where to find an ice crystal, don't think, oh, I'm sure I'll find it eventually, because you can find it in the damn dunes, which is one of the hottest places, and it doesn't make any sense. There's no shame in not knowing something about Monster Hunter, because there is so much to know about Monster Hunter. So swallow your pride, go online, and just look it up. Honestly, it's not a spoiler. It's just a helping hand. You've still got to do the whole killing of the monster thing, so just take a breather and have a look online to find out where to get Dragonite ore. Just do it.
And there you have it. I hope this video has helped you if you're a little bit worried or a little bit maybe apprehensive about picking up the game and realize that whilst, yes, it is a very complex game, it does sort of, you just sort of find your way through. It's a very sort of organic and natural and flowing process. It's scary at first, but you'll get into it. Don't worry. And it's so, so worth it. There's no game series more rewarding than Monster Hunter, trust me. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then why don't you convince that subscribe button that everything's absolutely okay. And please just check out NintendoLife.com for all sorts of lovely Nintendo-related content. Thank you again for watching. Bye-bye.